Okay, Om Jnana Timarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksurunmilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Tanya Prabhu Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we're reading the Brihad Bhagavatamrita. And we're on the second half of the book where how he travels.
Maharaj, there's some broke up. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Maharaj.
So he got into Vaikuntha, and he saw, in Vaikuntha all the residents had four arms, and they all look alike.
他旅行到了百昆塔。 白坤塔所有人长得都很像, 他们都长得都有四臂。
So, Sanatan Goswami is explaining to us that there's no envy among any of the people in Vaikuntha.
Sanatana Goswami 给我们解释说, 在无忧星宿, Vaikuntha 不存在嫉妒。
And all the residents of Vaikuntha, they all have very good qualities. They cooperate together in perfect harmony with each other.
白昆塔的居民呢，都拥有优秀的好品质，他们彼此合作，完美的和谐共处，彼此之间其乐融融。The
residents of Vaikuntha, they may look like ordinary materialistic sense enjoyers of the material world. But they are actually great souls who are worshipped by liberated souls.
白昆塔的居民呢，好像是普通的物质感官享乐者，但是他们都是受到解脱的灵魂所崇拜的伟大的灵魂。
So the devotees of Vaikuntha, they enjoy their senses in wonderful ways. They have a life full of song and dance.
Vaikuntha的奉献者们都以一种奇妙的方式享受自己的感官，他们是载歌载舞。
So someone may judge them, someone may think of them as being just like ordinary, selfish, materialistic people in the world of Maya.
Yeah, 在玛雅控制之下的感官享乐者。
Okay, I think you have to say what say that again.
Yes, Maharaj.
G.
Yeah. 就是在百昆特的奉献，就是有的人以为，百昆特的奉献者呢，他们都是自私自利的感官享乐者。
But actually, these people who live in Vaikuntha are worshipped by all the great souls.
但事实上，瓦昆特的奉献者都受到伟大灵魂的崇拜。
Great souls mean people who have they're no longer interested in material energy. They're not attracted by sense gratification.
伟大的灵魂的意思是说，他们对于物质的感官享受不感兴趣，他们已经不受到物质能量的影响了。
They're fully dedicated to the service of the Supreme Lord.
他们全心全意地投入到对至尊主的服务当中。
And the devotees of Vaikuntha they're not attached to any enjoyment to the material senses.
百昆特的奉献者们，他们不会依附物质的感官享受。
In the Srimad Bhagavatam, Lord Brahma describes about Vaikuntha. In the third canto, chapter 15.
主 Brahma 就在圣田伯加瓦坛第三篇第十五章是这样描述瓦昆特的。
He describes that in the Vaikuntha planets, the inhabitants are flying in their airplanes in the company of their wives.
他形容说，在瓦昆特无忧星宿。那里的居民呢，是在他们妻子的陪伴之下，乘坐的飞机在翱翔。
And along with their wives, along with their wives, they eternally sing the character and activities of the Lord.
他们和妻子们一起，永恒的在歌唱着主的品质和活动。
And the qualities of the Lord, the qualities, the activities of the Lord are always auspicious.
主的品质，主的活动都是永恒的吉祥。
And while they're singing about the Lord, they have no interest in the presence They have no interest in the presence of the blossoming Madhavi flowers which are blooming in the water and which are fragrant and laden with honey.
当他们忙于歌唱主的品质和活动的时候，他们就对池塘里绽放的 Madhavi 鲜花不感兴趣。这些鲜花都充满着花蜜。
So we should understand that even while they're enjoying the devotees in Vaikuntha are enjoying, they're always absorbed in the ecstasy of worshipping the Supreme Lord.
所以我们要明白，尽管白昆特的人们，他们虽然在享受着生活，但他们总是处在对主的狂喜之爱中。
That the flower, the Madhavi flower, will bloom during the spring. And that's when the people are very absorbed in thought of sense enjoyment.
Madhavi鲜花呢，是在春季就开始绽放，这就使得人们。 使得人们禁不住要去从事感官享受。
So even though these flowers are very attractive and it may attract the senses of the devotees, it does not take away their, it doesn't distract them from devotional service.
虽然这些鲜花都非常有吸引力，但却无法使奉献者的感官从奉献服务上感到分神儿。Vaikuntha
is always full of devotees who. And these devotees never do anything but bow down to the feet of Lord Hari.
Vaikuntha 充满着奉献者，而这些奉献者，他们唯一要做的就是去顶拜主哈瑞的莲花足。
They travel in aeroplanes, which are made of lapis lazuli, emerald and gold.
他们乘坐，白昆塔奉献者乘坐的飞机是由流苏、黄金和lapis 这种名叫 lapis 这种材料所做成的
，an emerald and gold，
还有黄金，还有
emeralds， a precious stone，
还有这种珍贵的宝石所组成
，and they're always surrounded by their different consorts, who are very beautiful women with big, large hips and beautiful, smiling faces.
他们就由他们的同伴所环绕着。这些美丽的女子们全都长着就高耸的宽大的臀部。 以及盈盈的笑脸。
So these people from Vaikuntha, they're not interested in any kind of passionate activities. And by enjoying the beautiful women.
Vaikuntha的居民从来不会对那些激情的活动，例如去享受美女这样的激情的活动所感兴趣。
Even though they're with these ladies, they're not, they don't forget the service to the Lord.
尽管他们都和这些美女为伴，却从来不会忘记对主的服务。
So even karmis and gyanis and yogis, they cannot hope to get anything for their sense gratification, like a devotee.
连那些了不起的业报工作者、思辨家和瑜伽师，他们都不，无法指望能得到奉献者所得到的感官享受。
They can never hope to enjoy like what the devotees of Vaikuntha enjoy.
他们是无法指望能像 Vaikuntha 奉献者那样去尽情的享乐。
But although the people in Vaikuntha are enjoying, they're never being degraded. They're always fixed in the mode of pure goodness.
虽然Vaikuntha的奉献者在享受，但他们却从来不会降格堕落。他们总是专注于纯粹的奉爱之中。
The devotees of Vaikuntha are perfectly fixed in service to the Supreme Lord Narayan.
Vaikuntha 奉献者总是完美的处在对 Narayan 的服务当中。
So they have actually come to the eternal platform.
他们实际上已经达到了完美的层面。
But they show all different kinds of changes. When they take part in the Lord's pastimes, they can change in different forms.
当他们参加主的逍遥时光的时候，他们的身体形体是可以随心所欲的变化。
So in the Lord's pastimes, there are two different kinds of pastimes. There's in one pastime, the Lord will be it will be the mode of opulence. And in another pastime, it will be sweetness.
主的逍遥时光分为两种类型，在一种逍遥时光当中，主展示了他的富裕。在另一种逍遥时光，主展示了他的甜美。
So the devotees take part. The devotees who take part, they pretend to change, to go through different changes, but they do this just to create varieties to give pleasure to the Lord.
奉献者，当奉献者参与主的逍遥时光的时候呢，他们假装是在变化着，但这种变化是创造出一种丰富多彩的氛围，好给主带来快乐。
So in Vaikuntha, there is no force of nature forcing people to do anything he doesn't want to do.
在百昆塔无忧星宿，没有什么自然界的力量能够强迫人们去做违心的事儿。
The only force which is influencing the devotees is the force of pure love.
唯一的能够强迫奉献者的力量，就是奉献者自身所蕴含的纯粹之爱。
And by the influence of that force, they will act for the pleasure of Lord Narayan.
由于这种力量，奉献者们会为了主 Narayan 的快乐而去活动。
So all the residents of Vaikuntha are equal, but at the same time, they also show different individual variety.
Vaikuntha 的居民，他们都是平等的，与此同时，他们也展示出多样性。
So in Vaikuntha, everything is like that. Everything is meant for the pleasure of the Lord.
在 Vaikuntha, 每样事物都是为了主的快乐而存在着。
Because the Lord wants to enjoy different pastimes, so his devotees will arrange for the pleasure of the Lord. So the devotees are all equal on the platform of pure spiritual existence, but they assume different forms and positions for the service of the Supreme Lord.
Vaikuntha 的奉献者们，他们都平等地处在纯粹的灵性存在当中。但是他们的形象和他们的地位都是完美的契合于对至尊主的服务。
Even objects in the Vaikuntha which appear to be inanimate, they're actually of the same transcendental nature.
在 Vaikuntha, 即便是那些无生气的物体，也都拥有同样超然的本质。
So the airplanes, the trees, the houses, they're all perfect living beings.
那里的飞机、树木、房屋都是完美的生物。
And they're all one with the Lord and with other living entities.
他们和主以及和其他的生物体都是一致的。
And they appear in whatever form the Lord requires for his pleasure.
无论主，为了主的快乐，主做出什么样的要求，这些生物体都会做出，他们都会显现出相应的形象。
Sometimes the Vaikuntha will appear full of riches, will appear to be full of gold and jewels.
有时候，Vaikuntha 呈现出一派富裕的景象，充满着到处都是黄金珠宝。
And sometimes the atmosphere there will appear like chalk. It will appear so white, like a thick cloud of moonlight.
而另外一些时候，那个瓦昆特的氛围就好像非常浓密的、很厚的白色的云朵。
So in the material world, things like gold and jewels and moonlight are the most attractive things in the material world.
在物质世界，黄金、月光 和珠宝都是，非常有魅力的。
But they only appear, they only have a dim reflection compared to the attraction of the Vaikuntha world.
与外昆塔无忧星宿的吸引力相比，物质世界的这些事物都显得暗淡无光。
Vaikuntha has to be understood just by its spiritual influence, no other way.
人们只能这样去理解外昆塔，无忧星宿拥有一种灵性的影响力，除此之外，他们无法理解 Vaikuntha。
We can understand the Lord of Vaikuntha and know the different places of his pastimes only when he reveals himself by his special potency.
我们一个人他只能，除非主揭示，予以揭示，否则的话，人们是无法理解瓦昆塔之主的逍遥时光，以及他向阳逍遥时光的这些地点，除非主，通过特殊的能量揭示他自己。
This is actually his mercy potency by which we can understand him.
这实际上是主的仁慈能量，透过他的仁慈能量，我们才可以明白他。
And a devotee who gets the mercy of the Lord, they can use their spiritual intelligence to understand about the nature of Vaikuntha.
透过主的仁慈的能量，奉献者才可以去理解瓦昆塔。
They can compare it to things which they have seen and touched, and which they've met with in the material world. They can compare it.
他们可以用他们在物质世界所见到的，以及所触碰到的，用这些切身体验来去理解。
And the devotees who are fully pure, and if they're fully purified, they can see Vaikuntha directly.
非常纯净的奉献者是可以直接见到瓦昆塔的。
But the mind and senses, the material mind and senses, they can never understand the spiritual existence.
物质的心意和感官是永远无法理解灵性的存在。
So, if they try to make themselves an authority based on that, then they can only do that if they're graced by the Lord's mercy.
谁想要权威的谈论瓦昆塔，必须要得到主的仁慈。
Actually, even by direct experience, no one can properly understand Vaikuntha.
事实上，透过直接的 人可以透过直接的体验去理解白坤塔。
So, Gokumar is telling like this. He's telling that I cannot accurately describe everything.
Gopakumar 就说，事实上，我是无法准确的来描述，加以描述的。
A conditioned soul, he can discover the world of Vaikuntha only if he sees the higher if he sees the reality for himself.
受条件限制的体空灵魂，想要去发现百坤的话，他只能去自己，自己去直接的去亲眼见，去直接的去见到这份真实的景象。
Yeah, he has to actually see it for himself. If he hears about it from someone else, then he'll only get a little bit, a glimmer of understanding. He won't understand much.
倘若他只是去听，透过聆听，他只能去隐隐约约的去理解一点。除非他自己亲眼去见到这些景象。
But if a devotee is eager for Krishna's service, if he hears the instructions of his spiritual master and faithfully practices the discipline, then such a guru can recommend that, and the devotee gradually becomes pure.
如果一个人很渴望去服务 Krishna， 并且去聆听他灵性导师的训示，忠心耿耿地去修习这些规范，那么他的 guru 就可以把推荐这个人，使得这位奉献者变得非常纯粹。
So when his faith is strong, then he can see the spiritual world.
当他的信心变得非常强大的时候，他就可以见到灵性世界了。
And then, by actually seeing it, then his knowledge can become perfect.
通过直接的来见到这个景象，他的知识就变得完美了。
But if he just hears from somebody else who has seen it, that is not enough.
如果他只是仅仅的去聆听某一位以自己，如果他只是去聆听，那位亲眼见过这景象的奉献者去讲述的话。那这还不够。
We have to become a disciple of someone who is an authority, and we have to accept the discipline, and then. That would lead to self-realization.
一个人必须去做一位权威的门徒，并且接受他的规范、约束，这样他能够得到自我觉悟。
And then when you see the the splendors of Vaikuntha, then the happiness of Brahman is realized.
当他见到 Vaikuntha 的壮丽、绚丽、壮，壮丽的景象，那么就可以觉悟到 Brahman 了。
No, wait. When he sees Vaikuntha, then he'll understand that the happiness of Brahman was nothing, was empty.
哦，纠正一下，就是。他当他见到壮丽的 Vaikuntha 的时候，他就会明白到 Brahman 梵是不值得一提的。梵是微不足道的。
And that so-called happiness of Brahman, it just disappears.
所谓的，梵带来的快乐，梵带来的所谓快乐就会消失。
So when a Vaishnava is purified, then he can go on and realize the glories of Vaikuntha.
当一位 Vaishnava 变得净化之后，就能够觉悟到 Vaikuntha 的荣耀了。
And then he will have no attraction. The impersonal realization will be not attractive to him any at all.
非人，那么非人格的事物就会不再吸引他了。
Yeah, the attraction towards impersonal realization will just disappear, just like the stars disappear as the sun rises in the morning. In the morning.
非人格觉悟，他就不再受非人格觉悟的吸引。这就好像当旭日东升的时候，天上的星星就会消失不见。
So, Gop Kumar goes on to describe qualities which are necessary to enter into the path of devotional service.
Gop Kumar 就继续形容一个人必须具备哪种品质，才能够走在奉爱服务的道路之上。
They should be self-satisfied.
这样的人他应该是非常自我满足的。
And they should be free, they should not have any material concerns.
他们也不应该充满物质的焦虑。
And they should have given up everything that they know and possess.
他们不应该有任何拥有感。
And they should have associated with Vaishnavas, and they should have acquired the power to distinguish between what is essential and what is not essential.
他们应该已经获得了 Vaishnava 的联谊， 并且他们有分辨力，可以分辨出什么是关键的，而什么是无足轻重的。
So when we have these kind of qualities, then we can enter into the path of devotional service.
一旦我们拥有这样的品质，就可以踏上奉爱服务的道路。
So Gokumar's student had been told that only direct perception could help him to understand the real nature of Vaikuntha.
苏帕库马尔的学生呢，就被告知说："只有去亲身的体察，他才能够理解外昆特的真实本质、本性。
Yeah, he has to see it for himself to understand it.
”为了理解外昆特，他必须自己亲眼去见证。
But he may be the student may be anxious to have some other way to get that faith. To understand, in order to understand Bhakti Yoga.
为了明白 Bhakti Yoga 奉爱瑜伽，这个学生呢，也许会渴望通过其他的方式来获得信心。
So Gop Kumar is describing a logic, a special logic, by which we can know the happiness of Vaikuntha.
就形容了一种特殊的逻辑，来去理解百坤的快乐。
Some advanced yogis, mystics, they may have realized the Supreme in his impersonal feature.
某些进步的精进步的瑜伽师或者玄密主义者，他们也许已经透悟了至尊主的非人格本质。
But they will give up that happiness of Brahman when they get the opportunity to understand Vaikuntha.
一旦这些人有机会去明白百昆塔，他们就会放弃这种对 Brahman 执着于 Brahman 的快乐。
They will forget, they will put aside all their knowledge and their advanced realization in order to enter the path of devotional service.
他们必须要把他们这些所谓的知识和所谓的这些进步的觉悟放在一边，才能够走进奉献服务的道路。
And once they experience the bliss of Vaikuntha life, the life in Vaikuntha, then they will condemn what they used to think was happiness and impersonal realization.
一旦他们体会到 Vaikuntha 无忧星宿的极乐的生活，他们就会谴责他们以前以为的所谓的非人格觉悟的带来的快乐。
So this is the wonder of Vaikuntha.
这便是百坤的奇妙之处。
So Gop Kumar was standing at the doors to Vaikuntha and he was seeing people come and go. And he thought, what kind of lord must it be who has so many, who has such servants?
东哈库尔此时此刻是站在百昆特的大门边上，他看着进进出出的人们，心里纳闷说：“什么样的主会拥有这样的仆人呢？”
So after seeing so many beautiful and opulent servants of Lord Narayan coming through the gate to Vaikuntha, Gop Kumar was wondering how, he was thinking how wonderful and beautiful must Lord Narayan be because his servants are so attractive.
You 见到了这些美丽又富裕的仆人，站在百坤的大门口的格鲁帕库马尔禁不住就想：“如果仆人都是这么美丽和富裕，那么主纳瑞安呢？他会是拥有何等的美丽，何等的富裕啊？”
Yeah, ma the master, one who's a real master, must be superior in every respect to his servants.
一位真正的主人一定是在各个方面都优越于他的仆人。
So Gop Kumar said, I was thrilled, I was so del happy as I waited in the gateway of Vaikuntha.
狗帕库马尔说：“当我在白昆特的大门口，我矗立在那里等待的时候，我浑身上下充满了快乐，我身体都感到毛发直竖。
And Gop Kumar said, I was so excited, I stood up and sat down, and stood up and sat down, and waited for the associates of the Lord to come back.
罗帕库马尔说：“我感到非常的兴奋，我一会儿起站起来，我一会儿又坐下来，我时而起立，时而坐下，这样反反复复的等待着主的同游回来。
So eventually the associates of the Lord came back and they escorted Gop Kumar inside.
”最后，主的同游终于回来了。就陪同着格鲁帕库尔走进了百昆特的大门。
And then Gop Kumar could see more wonderful than wonderful. He could see the thousand-headed Anantasesha would be unable to describe even in the lifetime of Brahma.
格鲁帕库尔，他此刻就见到了。最奇妙的事物还要奇妙的，主那千头有1000个头颅的主阿南塔，这是无法形容的，连主布拉玛用他一生的时间也都无法形容。
Anantashesha is always describing the glories of the Lord, but even he could be unable to describe all these opulences, all the glories.
主阿南塔西沙，他不停的在荣耀着至尊主，但是即便这样，他也无法充分的描述主的富裕和荣耀。
So the people who were escorting Gop Kumar, they had gone inside to tell the Lord that Gop Kumar had arrived. And when the Lord heard that Gop Kumar had come, then he immediately told them to bring him inside. He didn't want to keep Gop Kumar waiting any longer.
陪同陪呃，Gopakumar的人这时候就进去向主禀告说，Gopakumar来了。当主一听说Gopakumar来了，他就命令立刻把他带进来，他不希望Gopakumar在外面等待。
So when Gop Kumar entered into Vaikuntha, he saw so much, it was so wonderful, he could not even describe, he could not begin to describe it.
当Gopakumar进入Vaikuntha的时候，他见到奇妙的景象，他简直无法形容。
This student who was with Gop Kumar would have to be satisfied with just an outline of his experience.
Gop Kumar的学生，他只能是通过聆听到一个大概情况，他就通过聆听到一个大概。 大致的情况，他就应该满足了。
So Gop Kumar entered in, but then there were more gates. There were several gates, one after another, and at each gate he was met by different doorkeepers who allowed him to enter only after they announced his arrival to their superior.
杜帕库马尔就穿过了一道门又一道门，好几个大门，每一个大门呢都有守门人，而每一个守门在每一个大门的守门人呢都高声的向他们的上级通报来人。
At each gate, Gop Kumar could see the guards offering obeisances to the local superintendent, the person who was in charge.
每一个大门的保安就向他们的当地的上级主管顶拜。
But Gop Kumar was thinking that this must be the Lord of the universe.
但是，Gopakumar以为这就是宇宙之主。
And Gop Kumar would offer obeisances and bow down and recite prayers.
Gopakumar便也一同顶拜，并且献上祈祷。
So Gop Kumar was so eager to see the Lord of the universe that he was mistaking the different devotees. He was thinking this is the Lord, or this is the Lord, but they were only the Lord's devotees.
Gop Kumar 是如此的渴望，迫切渴望见到宇宙之主。他每见到一位奉献者，就以为这就是宇宙之主了，主，他就是主。 但实际上，他们都只是奉献者。So
at each gate, they were met by the local manager, and each gate there was more opulence. It was becoming more and more opulent. It was astounding to Gop Kumar.
在每一个大门。 都有当地的主管，而每一个大门都比前一个大门显得更加富丽堂皇，令Gopakumar瞠目结舌。
So Gop Kumar was becoming more and more eager to see Lord Narayan.
这使得Gopakumar越来越渴望去见到主Narayan。
So finally, the Supreme Lord had some compassionate men who were guiding him, taking care of Gop Kumar, and they told Gop Kumar about the special signs by which you can recognize the Lord.
有一些至尊主的心怀怜悯的陪同者，陪同着Gopakumar的人，就对他心怀怜悯，告诉他，主Narayana他是拥有特殊的标志。
And they taught Gop Kumar what kind of prayers to recite and what etiquette he should observe.
他们也教导Gopakumar应当背诵什么祷文，应当遵守何种礼仪。
So the escorts, they told Gop Kumar how Lord Narayan has special marks, like on his chest there's the Sri Vatsa mark.
Gopakumar的陪同人员告诉他说，主Narayana他拥有着特殊的胸膛，拥有特殊的Sri Vatsa标志。
And there's a few special features which are only there on the Lord of Vaikuntha, which distinguish him from all the other devotees.
Vaikuntha之主，他拥有几个特殊的标志，使得他和Vaikuntha的其他居民就分开。
Because many devotees, they have achieved liberation with the same bodily features as the Lord, but still there's some special marks on the Lord which distinguish him.
因为有的奉献者就获得了与主有同样形体的解脱，但至尊主他拥有他本身独特的身体特征。
And the people who were with Gop Kumar, they felt sorry for him, that he didn't know how to recognize the Lord. So they told him this, and they also taught him how to behave in front of Lord Narayan.
为他感到难过，因为他不知道主拥有这样的特征，而且他们也教导他应当拥有什么样正确的礼仪。
And they told him that first of all you have to bow down, and then stand up, but you should keep some distance away, don't get too close to him.
他们教导他说， 你首先应当顶拜，然后呢，你起身，但是你应该和主保持距离，不应该和主过于接近。And
the palms of the hands should be joined together, and you should look down at the Lord's lotus feet.
你应当双手合十，而且目光应该落在主的莲花足上。
And at that time, you shouldn't move, and you shouldn't show any different bodily transformations.
那个时刻呢，你身体不应当移动，你的身体也不应当展现出任何的变化。So
that this is the proper behavior in front of Lord Narayan.
这就是在主Narayan面前的正确的。
We can do it for the deities the same way.
我们可以在神像面前呢，也采取同样的 行为举止礼仪。
So Gop Kumar was brought through many different districts which were all very splendid with all different kinds of houses and gates.
库马尔就被带到了好几个街区区域，而这些区域都有不同的房屋大门。
And then he entered the most, the best of all, the most transcendental neighborhood. And he came to one palace. And the, at this place, the, there were many others waiting in attendance.
随后，戈帕库马尔就进入了一个超然的一个。超然的街区，在这个街区就有一座宫殿，在这个宫殿外面有许许多多的侍从等在那里。
So he came, Gop Kumar came to a palace. It was very opulent, overflowing in greatness.
最后，戈帕库马尔就来到一座宫殿前，这座宫殿已是一派富丽堂皇，而且看上去特别的宏伟。
It was radiant like millions of suns and moons, and it captured Gop Kumar's mind and his eyes.
这座宫殿。就放散发出璀璨的光芒，好像有上百万颗日月那样的散发的光芒。这样的景象就吸引了戈帕库马尔的心意和眼睛。
And just like a servant, just like many servants surround their master, there was one palace surrounded by many smaller palaces.
仿佛有许多的仆人围绕着一位主人，同样有许多其他的宫殿都环绕着一座主要的宫殿。
So that palace was so effulgent, it attracted Gop Kumar's mind and eyes.
这座宫殿是如此的辉煌。戈帕库马尔就禁不住目不转睛的专心致志的盯着这座宫殿。
So within the palace, Gop Kumar saw before him, some distance away, he could see the personality of Godhead, the Lord of Vaikuntha.
戈帕库马尔远远的就看见其主。这座宫殿当中矗立着坐着至尊性格神首，他就是瓦昆特之主。
And he was sitting on a golden throne which was shimmering with the glow of many jewels.
他坐在一座黄金的宝座上，这个宝，这次这个座位镶嵌着许多闪闪发光的宝石。
And he was sitting on a cushion that was of swan white cotton, and very fine and very attractive.
他坐在一个坐垫上。这个坐垫呢，就好像白天鹅那样的纯洁无瑕，是棉质的。
It was very clean and soft, and it was attractive.
坐垫非常的洁净柔软，吸引着人。
So there was a big cushion at the back on which the Lord was leaning with his left elbow and upper arm.
在，至尊人歌手神的身后呢，还有另外一个靠垫。至尊主他的左臂和臂膀和胳膊肘就靠在这个靠垫上。
So the Lord of Vaikuntha was the Lord of blossoming youth. He was a very young, he was y appearing very youthful and young, and he was blossoming. He was very handsome, very attractive.
外坤他的主，他现在是风华正茂、青春年少，而且相貌非常的俊美，有魅力。
So Gop Kumar had entered into the entrance hall of Lord Narayan's palace, so he could see him from a long way.
Gopa Kumar，他现在是走在这个宫殿的这个门廊，进门的这个大厅，所以他远远的就可以看见Vaikuntha 的主。
But he could only see him from a distance.
但他只能远远的去见这位外坤他之主，
But he could see the Lord sitting happily in right in front of him on a throne with cushions white like the moon.
他可远远的看到主外坤他之主坐在他的宝座上，他的坐垫好像是皎洁的月光一样的洁白。
So the Lord of Vaikuntha is the original person, but he didn't appear to be old. He seemed to be ageless.
虽然外坤的之主是原初之人，但是他看上去一点也不没有衰老的像样貌，他看上去，好
Yeah,
像是没有岁月的痕迹。
he was in the prime of youth. It appeared like he was in the prime of youth, the best part of youth.
他看上去是处在风华正茂的年纪。
So he was showing his opulences and displaying a youthful beauty that is one of the most attractive of his opulences.
他看上去非常的富裕，他拥有青春的美丽，而这正是他最有吸引力的一面。
Okay, so we'll stop here today.
那我们今天就讲到这里。
Have we got some questions from last week?
Yes. 我们先看一下上周留下的几个问题。 上星期的东西。好，我的第一个问题是。一个问题是，Braja，那是 Braja Rani Dasi。
Yeah.
呀，sorry, Mar, that's not the last time.
That's not what?
It's April. It's April. Last time. Should everyone aspire to go to Goloka Vrindavan, or someone's original constitutional position is in Vaikuntha? 第一个问题是说，是不是每个人都应该渴望去 Goloka Vrindavan 呢？还是说，有的人的原初的构成性地位本来就是在 Vaikuntha 呢？
Well, everyone will have their own particular nature, and they will be attracted to a particular place, a particular relationship, a particular atmosphere for the service of Krishna.
每个人呢，他们都有他们的特定的本质、本性，因此呢，他们就有相应的。特定的一个地方和主有一个特定的关系，还有一个特定的气氛，他在那里都可以服务 Krishna。
Now, followers of Lord Chaitanya, generally they will follow in the mood of the gopis. They are attracted, they want to cultivate that mood of the gopis. They consider that to be the topmost.
一般呢，主 Chaitanya 的追随者，他们希望培养的是 Gopi 牧牛姑娘的心态，他们认为这种心态是最高的。
But there are other devotees who are more Vaikunthavasis, like Narada Muni is a Vaikunthavasi.
但是有其他的奉献者呢，他们是更倾向于。Vaikuntha 的心态，比如说 Narada Muni，他就是 Vaikuntha 的居民。
And in the other sampradaya, like in the Lakshmi sampradaya, the Sri Vaishnavas, they all cultivate the mood of Vaikuntha. They're not attracted to anything in relation to Krishna. Their mood is to worship the Lord in opulence, in Aishwarya.
有另外一个使徒传系是 Lakshmi 的使徒传系 Sri Sampradaya，他们就深深的受到 Vaikuntha 的吸引，他们是崇拜的主的，是在 Aishwarya 这个心态当中崇拜主。
Okay.
第二个问题是，顶拜 guru，有人对我传教说，传教发展奉献者比喂养奶牛重要，请问这是正确的吗？Obeisance to guru. Someone told me preaching and cultivate
No,
the.
I don't want to get into these things with the
Okay,
issues about.
okay. 那我们看下一个问题，因为这个没有什么关系跟我们的课程。下一个问题是 Hare Krishna，顶拜 Guru，顶拜所有奉献者，拜 Kunta 的部队起什么作用？拜 Kunta 的部队，Guru，what is the function of the troop of Vaikuntha?
What is the function of the truth?
Army. 您这个问题不太清楚，您再问一遍吧。Maybe 我 ask the devotee to raise the question again. It's not so clear. 我们看下一个问题，Hare Krishna。顶拜孤奉献者，请问拜昆特的居民没有嫉妒，我们应该如何得到这样的好品质？
Well, we have to clean the heart. We have to get rid of the envy by hearing and chanting. And that way we will be get free of envy.
我们应该净化我们的心内心，去除掉这些，通过聆听和唱诵来去除这些不好的品质，这样不就可以摆脱嫉妒了？That is all the question from last time.
Oh, okay. So then we'll stop here then.
Yes.
So, thank you, Guru Mani, for your translation.
Thank you,
We'll
Maharaj.
thank Padmamukhi, Ganshin Yaman. Okay, Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Jai.
Go back to Vrinda ki jai.
Jai.